Oh, here comes the sun.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Hotter than hell, isn't it? Anyways, this is what C20 looks like. We're gonna put this on the YouTube, so. Looks like it's plenty of space for a bigger RV, too, because ours, I think, is a... I want to say it's a 31. No, it can't be that long either. I think it might be a 27. We never did measure it from bumper to bumper. Gotta get a tape measure or something. Long tape measure.
I thought it was like a banana tree, but I don't think it is.
How you doing?
I don't look like it, but I don't think it is.
I don't know what those are. I don't know why I didn't see that before, but bananas grow in bunches anyway, so that's not that. I don't, unless it's a plantain tree. I don't know if plantains grow in bunches either, but could be poisonous, you never know. What? Rocks over here. I don't know if they want to take it over here. There's a lot of rocks over there under on the close to the shoreline here. You're gonna bottom out. You get too close. It's not the kind of boat to be taken over here. Oh man, you're gonna scrape in a minute. You're gonna put a hole in the bottom of that thing.
Do we want to walk, try to go to the front and ask them how much it is to add the truck for one night?
The website says $25, but I think they, I don't know, something like that. That seems like a lot for an extra vehicle, though.
It used to be like $6.
Yeah.
$7 a night back in the day, because we used to do the, when we went camping for that couple days.
I think it's inflation, though.
Adding an extra vehicle wasn't very much.
Yeah.